assume that the gun is loaded. Let's wait for questions to be asked. So I'm going to take the ramrod, place it down. You hear the ping? It's metal on metal. So that tells me that this weapon is indeed empty. So, I'm going to take my gunpowder. Place it down the barrel of the weapon.
What happens if you put that inside?
You said questions at the end.
Yeah. And then I'm going to take the casing, or the cartridge, and place it down the barrel, making it into a wad, which is then going to pack the gunpowder nice and tight. Down there. And you notice it doesn't have that pinging noise. So this gun is loaded. Now I'm going to bring my flintlock back to half cocked.
Awesome.
Take my priming powder, fill the pan. It doesn't, as you can see, it doesn't take that much to prime this weapon.
So guys, it's kind of like our food troughs at school, like the lunch trays. You know, the walls aren't very high, but it's a little bit like that. He's basically got a little food trough for his powder in there to keep it there. It's not flat. It's kind of like a food trough.
Thank you. Mm-hmm. So now what's going to happen is a chain reaction from the flint and the steel. The flint's going to strike the steel and create a spark that's going to catch the 4F on fire. So what I'm going to need, the count of three, yes, cover your ears and yell as loud as you can, fire in the hole. Ready? One, two, three.
Fire in the hole!
Clear front! Fire!
Ah! That's
I
want
to
Clohaya.
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 That's right.
It's a lot of work. It's like you ever take the skin off the chicken. Watch me take the skin off the chicken.
Okay.
Nice. Yeah.
What
did
you
mean?
Did you
cannon? A cannon sends a ball a long ways. Look at the rattlesnake skin.
So I get this?
Yeah.
Oh, can I have that hat one? Can I have that hat one?
No, that's mine. I've had it for a while.
I have
another feather. Let's see, what can we make him unshy with? Oh, I don't know.
The cannon.
Well, wait. He's out there in the woods, we say, it's time to come home. We can't yell at him because he can't hear us. So we shoot that big cannon. He can hear that for miles. He says, oh, I gotta get back to camp. So he brings back his meat or whatever he's caught or shot. And that's telling him to come on home.
So that tells him he's...
Cool. Good. You got your tractor book today, huh?
Yeah, it's a cool book.
Oh, yeah, it's a neat tractor. Johnny Tractor. Very cool. What do you think, what kind of bird do you think that came from?
I don't know.
Big bird, maybe like a hawk or something.
Maybe it came from Big Bird.
Big bird.
Oh, maybe it came from a giant bird.
Maybe. That might be.
Yeah. Come on, Brandon.
You need to cover our ears so hard. It will go right past.
Yes.
When they do this, it's going to break my heart. Like here, this far?
Yeah.
Like 10 feet away from it?
Yep. This is the Colusa-Sacramento State Recreation Area. It is October 12th, Friday, at 11:40 a.m. And we are getting ready to watch the... These are the guys that come up from Sutter Fort to do the cannons and the old days stuff, trapping and gold mining and all that kind of stuff, so... And
they would have to let them show you why they're putting the lunches right there though. I don't know what happened to St. Raymond at all. I do know what happened to the big school. She called me, Kelly called me and said they couldn't get buses, but not St. Raymond. St. Raymond never called me, so I don't know why they didn't show.
That's a
cancer
party.
Yeah.
Wait, the lunch is not anywhere. We'll be finished there. Over there will be fine. They want to use those or anywhere down here, biscuits. Or anywhere down there.
Caffrey, yep. Messing in the truck. He was just looking for mice.
Why was just looking for mice?
Because there was a guy came up here had mice in his truck. And Caffrey went in and got all the mice out. Okay, Brandon, here they go. That's right. There it goes, Brandon. Watch your ears. Now. Did that scare you?
Yeah.